So both players in form right now. It's a best of seven men's singles quarterfinal. Fan Zhendong will start with the serve. Love ball.
One love.
Tight serve, forehand flick. Now, one thing that I haven't mentioned yet, these tables are very fast. The ball is sliding on the top, so a lot of serves are coming long, which means we're going to see more flick receives.
One off.
You can hear the sound of the bounce, too. Bounce is also quite high on the tables. But a long serve from Fan Zhendong to get right into the rally. Again, the push game, it's going to be tough to keep the ball short. We're going to see more flicks. We're going to see more open rallies and quicker rallies.
2-1.
Now, Jung Young Shik got invited to play the Chinese Super League after putting up quite a fight at the Olympic Games in 2016 in Rio. After playing very close with some of the top Chinese players,
2-1.
It was clear that not only did China need a little bit of practice against him, but he might be a good competitor to see in the league. Looking down at court to see possible lighting in the background, occasionally flash photography going off.
Let 2-1.
But in terms of playing the Chinese Super League, Jung Young Shik very strong over the table. Now with his build, he's also finding himself behind the table a bit.
One,
a little bit lankier, but the service game right now, again, that second bounce on the table, and even the first for that matter, the ball comes long here. Serves will drift off the table. That's why the players come in early to practice, get familiar. Soft opening from Fan Zhendong, but the strong backhand. Jung Young Shik taking advantage of the opportunity. Soft touch, and the quick backhand, wide angle. Could see the exhale, the stress on Fan Zhendong's side.
4-2.
So with the first towel break, towel breaks come up every 6 points here. You might wonder, with a slicker table, who benefits more? Now, generally, the faster, younger players will have the advantage. The ball's moving faster. It's coming off the table long on the serve, so being able to turn and take a forehand and then chase down the next ball to the forehand line. Five long serve. Jung Young Shik playing dangerously. He's played a lot of risky serves so far. Fan Zhendong, you can understand the stoic facial expression there, almost the frown of Wang Hao, rather. Ma Long's kryptonite throughout his career. This one sits up just a little bit too loose from the back of the table. Fan Zhendong takes advantage. Again, it's a long match ahead. Game one here in the best of seven. It's going to be quite important for Jung Young Shik to keep the pressure on. Step around forehand, the follow-up power. Now, talking to Jung Young Shik after his loss with Ma Long, one thing he said was, I have no power. And of course, he's very humble, but he is saying relative to the top Chinese players, he doesn't have the ability to finish the point quite as easily. Not that same explosivity that Fan Zhendong has. Outstanding rally right down the line, a little bit off the top of the net, but when Jung Young Shik plays the parallel backhand here, lightning speed rally. He will not back off the table. So flexible in that wrist. It's the backhand over the table that makes Jung Young Shik dangerous. And the apology makes sure that it lands. Jung Young Shik wants to make sure. Fan Zhendong knows.
Seven.
Goes bold. He's been playing bold throughout. Fan Zhendong beats him to the backhand corner, says, step around this, son. A lot of different ways to go in that point. The two best choices for Fan Zhendong was one, what he did, or if he can make it down the line on the step around, the other way. Once again, holding his ground at the back of the table, Jung Young Shik right on top of the bounce. It's gonna be some conversation in that corner. The question is, will Fan Zhendong come back with a bit of victory here with the 1-0 lead? Quite deep in the hole right now.
Oh. 5-8.
Second time we've seen this in the short game where Jung Young-shik's ball has sat up a little bit. A lot of different ways for Fan Zhendong to accomplish that. Less rotation on the serve. Varying up the amount of spin with a similar contact, similar motion. Perfect length here. Jung Young-shik leaves Fan Zhendong handcuffed at the back of the table. Again, it's a risky shot to go for this opening. You could see him hold up the hesitation as he just cocks the wrist back to try to avoid hitting the racket on the table. Does not want to have to pull out the spare racket. And the tight serve inside the table. Heavy side, a little bit of under, and very subtle. Jung Young-shik with 5 game points to take the first in this best of 7. Domination in game number 1, a strong start, but still a long way to go. The underdog, the hometown favorite, Jung Young-shik, takes the 1-0 lead against Xiaopeng, and we'll be back for game number 2, coming up right after.
Time.
제가 쫓긴다고. 오케이? 응, 좋아. 스타트.
players come back to the table for game number 2. Fan Zhendong down 0-1 right now against Jung Young-shik.
Second game.
Now in terms of China versus the world, that used to be a tournament that was held. China, the top 3 players versus the top 3 from any other country in the world. And China won every time, quite decisively. I bring that up only to say that that is essentially table tennis, China versus the world. Right now, if there are any players around the world who can compete with the Chinese with any consistency, they're well studied, they're on the map. Beautiful setup, that push over the table. Jung Young-shik gets the wrist way back. You could see how much he surprised Fan Zhendong with that ball right there. Forced into submission, backed off the table in the opening forehand for Jung Young-shik. What a recovery from Fan Zhendong. The ball blasted right into the body. Still manages to get the forehand. Bring the ball back into play. Interestingly enough, a few Korean players causing threats to the Chinese right now, but no one with any consistency. Oh, break off the net for Fan Zhendong, but he withstands 2 parallel shots in a row. Jung Young-shik, again, playing some dangerous balls. Fan Zhendong with a quick apology there for the fortune, as he did not intend to hit the net. And it does give a distinct advantage, breaking the rhythm for the opponent.
2-3.
Just amazing how well practiced the players have to be out here. Another Korean player again, Lim Jong-hoon, against Ma Long with a match point in the 7th. Playing some incredible table tennis yesterday. An Jae-hyun at the World Championships, almost making it to the final, losing in the semis to Mattias Falk of Sweden.
Let
service, they'll play that again. And Jung Woo-jin at the Korea Open last year, the only player before Xu Xin, the first to take a triple crown on the world tour. So Korea quite strong right now, but still a few steps behind China.
3-0.
So with the first towel break, There's a lot of talk about the Olympic Games coming up. Every 4 years, this is the biggest tournament in the world, where more people are watching table tennis around the world than at any time. At any time. And the question is, with only two Chinese players, it seems quite likely that it'll be Fan Zhendong and it'll be Ma Long for the men. But who can challenge those two?
Time! 3-4.
So if Zheng Yung-shik could pull off this win, it would add a lot of question. In theory, if the Chinese national team decided not to send Fan Zhendong, what if they sent someone else who got more nervous under pressure? For the last 6 years, Fan Zhendong has been winning tournaments, and he's only 22. Another break off the net there. In English, the apology. Both players speaking some English. But again, tactically, Zheng Yung-shik has been playing very well with the tight serves, staying on top of the bounce, sometimes a little bit less rotation on the backhand as the table's very fast. Now you might think, why would that mean you should have less rotation? And it doesn't necessarily imply that. Simply that you need a shorter stroke because the ball reaches you faster. Doesn't quite bite into the table, grip the top surface, the playing surface of the table. So Fan Zhendong in the lead by one now on the receive. Trying to find that middle. Fan Zhendong covers well with the backhand and then turning to take the forehand from the pocket. In terms of safety, there is no safety against the Chinese national team, and especially against a player of Fan Zhendong's caliber. Again, just spent 14 months at world number one.
7-4.
Even with this receive, he rips it. The Chiquita over the table, deep to the backhand corner. How can that not be surprising? Because Fan Zhendong doesn't commit either way, stays neutral and waits.
Four, eight.
And a handcuffing serve right back. Gets a passive shot from Zheng Yung-shik. Now at the second towel break, I'll tell you that if Zheng Yung-shik wants to play passive, he was solid in the passive play over the table in the first game. Occasionally a long push that was surprising, using the wrist to deceive. But if he hesitates or he takes it a little bit late, it's going to be too tough to keep the push short here, or even half long for that matter.
Got it! 5-8.
But on the shorter side of half long, begs Fan Zhendong, baits Fan Zhendong to come in over the table. That Chiquita, where he's very strong in general. The Zheng Yung-shik with heavy side spin. Varying amounts of under and light topspin.
Left. 5-8.
Chin up high in the corner for Kim Tak-soo, watching very closely.
Nine,
you can hear the sound of the contact, that it's a little bit flatter from the backhand of Zheng Yung-shik. This is the difference between China and the rest of the world. The amount of rotation that the Chinese players get on it. Fan Zhendong calibrating a little bit, keeping the ball lower to the net rather than arcing it up. Still spinning though.
Nine, six.
But from over the table on top of the bounce, Zheng Yung-shik, when the ball arcs a little bit coming into him, is able to get that flatter shot with the backhand, drive it deep to the corner. Still using a little bit of wrist there at the end to keep some top spin on. Ooh, big ripping backhand. Zheng Yung-shik drops the racket low for that extra bit of backswing here. A bit more racket speed coming into the ball gets him within 2 points. Still down by two, sizing up the opponent, thinking, what's it going to be? Now remember, since October of 2016, coaches have been able to coach players between points. But at this level of play, this age group typically, the players are out here calling their serves for themselves. What an uncomfortable rally for Fang Zhendong. Zheng Yongshik manages to make it that way. Watch the placement on this shot from Zheng Yongshik. One wide, right into the middle, but gets Fang Zhendong taking the backhand. Good deception. Not much telegraphing here. 1 point to go. Zheng Yongshik with three in a row and a major one here on his second serve. Ooh, the long push again to the backhand. And the backhand attack to follow right into the body. Fang Zhendong is struggling right now. He's been under pressure before. We've seen him come back. He was down 0-1, 7-10 against Ma Long. The Asian Cup was able to take it. But a 2-0 lead right now for Zheng Yongshik, while it would guarantee him nothing, it would simply help his chances quite a bit against a player that he's never beaten despite six head-to-head attempts. Oh, break off the net again. They both had their share. Maybe a little bit more for Fang Zhendong, but it earns him a game point. Puts all his effort in here to turning for that forehand. Look how low he gets. You watch his left leg, the way he bends there. There's no question why he's so muscular through the legs to support such upper body movement. Game point for Xiaopeng. Oh, this one sits up a little bit high. The receive game trouble there after all that climbing back in from down 5-9 to 9-9. But Fang Zhendong does the job and finishes game two. We'll see what happens in game three. Who takes the lead? Game three coming up right after this.
Please avoid using flash when taking photos.
Time.
Welcome back for game number three, and you might have seen on screen, first of all, look how long the table looks from this camera angle. It's amazing from far back and up high how small the table looks with the players moving as fast as they are from their low stances. As Fang Zhendong makes sure the rubber is pressed flat. Again, players putting on new sheets of rubber, often in tournament play. Making sure their sheets of rubber are completely fresh for full grip and traction. Oh, turns the corner but gets burned going the other way. Fang Zhendong and that peripheral vision combined together to make that shot right there. That's a tough one for Zheng Yongshik. Not an easy ball, but also not an easy one to not feel bad about. When you have an opportunity like this, sitting up a little bit higher, that height, a little above belly button height, probably about twice the height of the net. High backhands can be very uncomfortable. I think Jorgen Persson, one of few who is so consistent.
Love to.
As fast and deep to that backhand corner as possible, testing Fang Zhendong. Saying, use your backhand or try to get around this ball. As fast as Fang Zhendong is, as flexible as he is, that still leaves him stretching. Right service.
1-2.
Parallel backhand, you could hear the grunt, that extra bit of effort and it was invested in spin. Jung Young-shik loads this ball with spin, a little bit of side on it as well. Could see it curve. Very interesting, again, the way the ball slides, the speed of the table, quite unusual.
Three, two.
Now, I talked about who the Chinese men will send to Tokyo 2020, and it seems likely that it's Fang Zhendong and Ma Long. But what about the Korean men?
Three, four.
While Lee Sang-soo has been the team leader for some time by world ranking, Jong Woo-jin has stepped in front for the past few months. And Jung Young-shik, currently world ranked number 20. They've quite a threat to Ma Long, is playing a close match here. Still a long way to go. Now the winner is determined by end game. If you start the match successfully, while it can help your chances, it is no clear indicator of the result. But if you end the match successfully, results written all over it, the Chinese national team seems to be very strong in closing out an end game. Now timing is going to be very important as well for Jung Young-shik when he's playing the slightly flatter shots. It's all relative. Again, we've seen flatter shots, but between the two players, Fang Zhendong playing with more spin. Oh, what a shot. The step around finds the short side of the table from way outside. Fang Zhendong goes out for a ride for this one. Look at this, no service here. Roaming charges may apply for that forehand. Oh, too pretty. Gets that head so low to get the upper body out of the way for that forehand shot, and it only gets him a one-point lead here. But right into the body. Pretty much the left hip is where this shot starts. Jung Young-shik challenging Fang Zhendong, trying to find that middle. Ooh, surprise, surprise. A bit of touch play from the powerful Fang Zhendong leaves it softly inside the table. It's one more passive shot and has Jung Young-shik waiting on the wrong corner. Check the text message. I told you to meet me on the other corner. Sounds really shady. Backhand serve, okay. Just missing the line here. Now from time to time, you'll see top players pull this out. Ma Long, probably the first that comes to mind. The most dominant player in the game turns to his backhand for a more simple serve with less rotation for a bit of shock factor, a bit of control, and just to change things up for the receiver. Like coffee beans at a fragrance shop, just something to cleanse the palate, reset. Oh, almost gets it back one more time. Another break off the net for Fang Zhendong. So Jung Young-shik has got a few in the bank now. Fishes it up, surprisingly able to keep the ball in play after leaving it as shallow as he did on the table. Doesn't miss this one by a lot, just the top edge of the racket. I've seen Jung Young-shik keep a lot of balls in play from behind the table.
Six.
Now this is the fine balance. It's not a question necessarily of simply reading the serve, but at a certain length, Jung Young-shik knows that he has to keep the push short or be surprisingly long with it, so tries to keep it very low to the net softly. Not an easy task. Successful shot to follow up that backhand. That very basic backhand serve. Looks basic, but it's a question of the third ball to follow. Light side forehand flick just with perfection there. Right into the Seamaster flag on the net. Second, third now backhand serve from Jung Young Shik in a row. Oh, set it up so well. The ball came back to the baseline. Jung Young Shik was set up for the backhand. But again, he's got one of the most powerful players in the world waiting on the other side. Could it have been the surprise factor? Fan Zhendong playing it right at the baseline. Either way, Xiaopeng here, Fan Zhendong up by two with the serves on his side. Cracking forehand, cracked right back. The quick turn to cover the middle, and Fan Zhendong up with three game points now. Physical fitness. Just looking at the leg strength from Fan Zhendong and the way he's able to get back up. Look at the quads. Look at him. It's tough not to. Touch for touch. Jung Young Shik saves a game point at the third towel break. He's down by two. Interesting, interesting. See, even in that touch game, as mentioned before, the ball comes long quite easily. Same with the service. Now, as we hear the Huaiting from the crowds, the Korean cheers, even some Xiaopeng fan club here. Again, the Chinese fans travel the world to show their support, their allegiance to the team. Two game points for Xiaopeng. Oh, ripping shot. Job finished in game number three. It's a 2-1 lead for Fan Zhendong, and we'll be back for game number four, Fan Zhendong versus Jung Young Shik, right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, please avoid using flash when taking photos. 请把对焦辅助灯关掉。
Players back for game number four. Jung Young Shik with a strong start, but again, as the Chinese national team tends to do, end the match successfully. Still only about midway through the match, potentially. Fan Zhendong at the top of the screen, one of the most dominant players on the planet, leading 2-1. He's won the last two games after being dominated 11-5 in the first, quickly turned things around. Beautiful backhand. Now, one thing about the lanky, long limbs of Jung Young Shik is that he's able to use that wrist with great flexibility to surprise Fan Zhendong. The more flexible your wrist is, the longer you can wait to determine your placement. It's going to be fired up for the rest of this match. I talked about how deep the Chinese national team runs. And if I haven't anyway, they run deeper than any team in the world. But the Korean men sent their number 10 player to the World Championships. That number 10 player you probably didn't know by name before the World Championships, but as avid table tennis fans and even mediocre table tennis fans just surfing the net right now or surfing the TV channels, An Jae-hyun, a name that is known around the world, was number 10 in Korea. Played the semifinals and almost the final at the World Championships. Cho Sung-min, another player from Korea right now, who's been playing incredibly well. So at least six men to watch out for wearing the Korean national team jersey. Aya.
Two, three.
Now, in terms of service errors, for those of you just tuning in thinking, I can serve the ball over the net. Not easy when you've got Fan Zhendong receiving on the other side who can punish a serve that sits an inch too high or comes an inch too long.
Got it!
Three all.
Or maybe a few centimeters for most of the world. So right back at 3 points apiece. Like the greatest medicine is laughter. I'd say one of the greatest threats to the Chinese national team is pressure. If you can get them nervous, and that takes taking an early lead. Oh, turns quickly. Fan Zhendong stays low. Zheng Yuanxik can't play it wide enough. Tries anyway. But this one's right to the corner. It's going to have to exit the side of the table to really cause trouble there for Fan Zhendong. Wow. Fan Zhendong with an outstanding chop block. Side and underspin, mostly side it looks like, as Zheng Yuanxik powers through the next ball. Full lunge there. That ball comes back. Zheng Yuanxik is left on the other side of the table. Doesn't miss by a lot. Top edge of the racket for Zheng Yuanxik. Again, very fast. This table's very fast. That in addition to Fan Zhendong on the other side. Arcing spin shot. A little bit lower one here. You can see it just skips out really fast. Oh, blocked by the net clamp. A dribbler off the top of the net. Wry smile there. Sure, fans of Zheng Yuanxik, many around the world will love that facial expression. But almost pulls a Fan Zhendong two on the net, skates. Now you might think he should play it closer to the baseline of the table, but he doesn't want to give the opening attack. He wants two bounces on the table.
Seven.
So
four.
Trying to play it close to the net clamp gives him that room for the roller. After all, that's what Fan Zhendong did against Simon Gauzy a few years back, 3 years ago now? The shot that went viral under the net clamp roller on the table. A little bit of hesitation there. Good placement. Fan Zhendong not with the hesitation. Forces the hesitation out of Zheng Yuanxik by playing it into the middle, right into the elbow. Right there, you could see Zheng Yuanxik was trying to play it out a little bit wide as Fan Zhendong turned the corner, but not wide enough. Again, with Fan Zhendong waiting, not committing too early. Yes, he had set up on the backhand corner, but he was well balanced. He wasn't moving around the corner anymore.
4-9.
Now, what started off looking very promising for Zheng Yuanxik is quickly turning to favor Fan Zhendong. That look, that expression. Oh, outstanding play. Fan Zhendong was surprised as a full 360, turning his back to the table to lob it. And after that, spinning it back into play from behind the table, this one. Little pirouette there. Ripping backhand, punched back down. Fan Zhendong finally missing a shot. He can lob. I've seen Fan Zhendong lob down players in the Chinese Super League, some of which you've seen on the world tour. Good parallel forehand here. Zheng Yuanxik can't change the past, but he's got a long way to go. 2 points in a row, a timeout here from Wang Hao in the corner. Fan Zhendong says, you know what, I've still got a 3-point lead. I'm feeling the pressure. We've seen a lot of the top players not looking so comfortable out here. And again, whether it's not being familiar with the table, whether it's something about the atmosphere, every spot on the world tour, every stop on the world tour, another anagram there, for spot, a little bit different. You're playing at different altitudes, you're playing in different humidities, with different lighting, with different air conditioning. But this is the life of a professional table tennis player. They're constantly traveling the world. Okay.
然后想好就坚定，对吧？在接发球的时候，我说话是这种给你啊，还是说这种给你打一下后面注意，还是有可能回你，回你完我去推一下后面接你，还是说有可能反正给你反正接两下，还要盯住啊，盯住这个啊，
Time.
Now again, for those of you newer to table tennis, Wong Hao, the best penhold backhand the world has ever seen. The best reverse penhold backhand in the game still, with the current world number one, Xu Xin, developing his all the time, getting better and better. Still, right now the bar has been set by the coach in the corner for Fan Zhendong. Second shot. Again, a little bit flatter than Fan Zhendong's. The trajectory is lower and straighter. But right out of the timeout, a big point. Game number two. Jung Young Shik came back to 9-9, and the next 2 points went to Fan Zhendong. Could be the same situation here, but he's got to get the next two. Bold long serve. Fan Zhendong keeps it baseline at the table. Makes it difficult for a flatter shot to come back. 3 game points for world number three.
Left, 7-10.
Not this time. No spin, no 360. Good surprise factor here, that forehand flick. Sometimes I talk about how important it is for taller players, but definitely for all players, having a forehand flick. Nima Ito is not especially tall, quite the contrary, yet still very strong over the table with the flick game. Game point saved, 2 to go. Fan Zhendong with the serves. Within one, getting dangerous. I mean, he's been dangerous, but the code red factor is getting deeper and deeper into that deep shade of red. Second serve here for Xiaopeng. Third game point, the nerves. Could it be the nerves? What placement, Jung Young Shik gets it wide enough out to the forehand to shut down the attack. Fan Zhendong goes around the corner, starts to make his move, and as his feet come down, there's not time to spring out to that wide forehand. Playing the risky shot to the short side pays off for Jung Young Shik. 3 in a row. He was down 4-9. Wins 2 points. Gets the timeout called on the other side. Now a serve back here at deuce in game number four. Oh, the net on the last shot there. What an outstanding point. One more time, fooled on the serve. Fan Zhendong from off balance saves it. It's funny, in terms, watch this one more time. Just that little clip off the net. But that's how much it means to Fan Zhendong. We've been seeing that from time to time with players lately. When they really are so excited to earn the point. But the fight continues. Another game point saved. Remember, he's got the entire crowd. I'd say probably 95% of the crowd behind him. Jung Young Shik. Covering with the backhands, coming out with the parallel shots as the crowd gets behind him. Jung Young Shik. Jung Young Shik, they say.
Left. 11-0.
To the forehand side, it's a game point for Jung Young Shik. If there is ever a turning point in the match, Winning this game right here would be crucial. Coming back from down 1-3 against Fang Zhendong is almost unheard of. By a non-Chinese player, no question about how much this means to Jung Young-shik right now on the receive with game point. He takes the game. We thought it was over. Fang Zhendong flying to the forehand, manages to keep the pressure on, but under pressure, Jung Young-shik, cool as a cube of ice. Two games apiece. We'll be back for game number 5. It's tied up. Don't go anywhere. Game 5 coming up right after this.
Time.
Back for game number 5. Look at that 9-foot by 5-foot table that is being pounded on by both players here. I'd say welcome back, but I know you haven't gone anywhere because these two players have given you no reason to go anywhere. Little break off the net here from Fang Zhendong. Again, the pressure continues to build as Jung Young-shik evens out the playing field with a spectacular finish to game number 4.
Love two.
Top of the net and out. You could hear the sound of the ball clipping the net on the way over. Again, when you play enough table tennis, when you watch enough table tennis, it's amazing how much of an indicator the sound is, even for the players at the point of contact on the service especially. A lot of people ask why players stomp their foot at the point of contact on the serve. That is one of the reasons, to mask the sound of the contact, to hide the amount of spin.
Got it! 1-2.
First point this game, Jung Young-shik giving the crowd a bit of what they give to him. It's a thing of beauty, that backhand of Fang Zhendong, how closed the racket is coming into the ball, almost parallel to the table. Quality push. This is about the 4th or 5th time we've seen it, but probably the 3rd memorable outright winner from Jung Young-shik with this push. Angle of the wrist, side swiping right to the corner. Just brushing under the ball. Well now, what a receive. Ball dangled wide to the backhand. A few different options here, none of which are easy, but Jung Young-shik takes one of the two, I'd say, best risks out here that he could have taken. Probably the best risk. Going wide cross court. Again, off the net, the Yole and the apology for the net almost simultaneously. That's the amount of pressure. Again, for the Chinese national team, there's no other team in the world that is expected to win every match they play against a foreigner. Think about what that means, how much pressure there is to perform out here, for Fang Zhendong especially. For Jung Young-shik, he's got the crowd behind him, but they're not watching expecting him to win. They're not watching him thinking if he doesn't win, he's failed us. They're hoping he wins. They're trying to power him to win, power him through with cheers and support. But it would be a massive upset if Jung Young-shik could pull this off.
Let's
Remember, they've played six times, and Fan Zhendong has won 100% of their encounters.
Let 3-4.
Fast, long serve into the backhand. It skips right off into that top edge. Again, the table is fast. And if you can surprise your opponent with this long serve, like a rock skipping on water, just gliding off the table into that backhand. Tied up at 4 points apiece. Soft Chiquita. Jung Young Shik being able to, it's weird. I don't want to say silence the crowd, but find that focus when you've got a stadium of fans cheering and you're out there with one person, your coach, Kim Tak-soo, in the corner. Are the fans with you? Yes, when you need them, you take them in. Oh, authoritative forehand, pounds on that ball. You could hear the sound of contact, how heavy that sounded. One chased, keeps it in play, but a little bit shallow. Fan Zhendong moves in to take advantage of the ball while it's still at its peak before it starts to dip. Shallow shots can be effective from time to time, especially with the opponent behind the table. But from that far behind, it's difficult. These backhands can be so fast and so fluid out here. Jung Young Shik, much like Oh Sang-un from the last generation of Korean strongmen, the top three, has that reach where he can play the ball from out in front with the backhand. Almost a deja vu point, but he takes the 2-point lead here. Second towel break. Now, score lines like this, nothing is guaranteed, but you start to imagine, what if? What if Jung Young Shik could continue with this point ratio and go up 3-2? Again, it was heartbreak for the Korean fans with Lim Jong-hoon yesterday, despite an incredible performance earning match point against Ma Long. And for Jung Young Shik against Ma Long at the last stop on the world tour. Chop block from Jung Young Shik. When have you seen that? From time to time, maybe. I can't remember the last time I've seen him do it. Right off the bounce. Not an ideal option, but if you can make it and you can keep it low, it can definitely break the rhythm of the opponent and force them to guess how much of what rotation is on it. 3-point lead for the Korean underdog on the receive. Oh, after all that work, he timed it so well. Fan Zhendong manages to save the point from behind the table. We've seen Fan Zhendong save so many points from different and difficult positions. As he starts to turn the corner, he's going the other way, but secured it. Again, efficient strokes. Still a 2-point lead, Jung Young Shik with the serves.
Let's 8-6.
I think Jung Young Shik serves more let services than anybody I've seen on the world tour, which might suggest incredibly high levels of practice on the serve.
Let's 8-6.
Meaning we don't see too many service errors. He keeps it so low, and the crowd applauds it. Keeps it so low that even if it hits the net, it only faintly hits the net. That's three in a row.
Eight,
at
six.
Least, right? I'm starting to lose track. It's always interesting for me to see how many let services in a row. I saw four recently. We've seen four now, at least.
Eight,
wow.
Six.
Now, it also makes you wonder, if you're in Jung Young Shik's position, do you go for a long serve here? Fan Zhendong might be ready for it. Maybe he's going to keep the serve tight once again, not afraid. Oh, and tries.
8-7.
Fan Zhendong gets in. That's 2 points in a row for Fan Zhendong and a timeout in the Korean corner. Still a one-point lead for Jung Young Shik. Now, it's a very common story to get to meet players on the world tour that have, I'd say, sad stories where they can tell you about the lead they had over a strong Chinese opponent. A Fan Zhendong, a Ma Long, a Xu Xin. I come into the tournament a little bit late. Adam, it was so close. I had 9-6, I had 10-8. I was up 2 games to 1, 3 games to 2. But in the end, to get through, the question is, what is it going to be for Jung Young Shik right now to capture? His long push has been very effective, deep to the backhand corner. Seeing Kim Tak-soo with that backhand opening, I'd imagine he's talking about Fan Zhendong's opening. Now, in terms of body language, only hearing a little bit of support, a little bit of the Mandarin in the corner from Wong Hao. You'd have to imagine, because of the physicality, that Jung Young Shik is a little bit taller. That means, one, he's got a bigger middle section, that crossover point that's difficult to get a powerful shot, but it also means he's going to be playing with the backhand more to cover the middle, as that is more efficient, which would force or encourage Fan Zhendong, rather, to play a little bit more to the forehand side of the elbow. To get that hesitation out of Jung Young Shik, we'll see. Second serve here. And a flatter backhand punched right back into the middle. It's a 2-point lead once again. And as we get into the business end of game number 5, as Don Parker would say, it's Jung Young Shik with the 2-point lead, 2 points away from a 3-2 lead. Wow, what a receive here. Jung Young Shik reads the no rotation. Very little rotation, leaves it just behind the net on the other side. 3 game points for Korea's Jung Young Shik. Oh, sprayed out to the wide forehand. Not with a 10-foot pull. Maybe with a 10-foot pull. Look how wide this ball is. Fan Zhendong redeeming himself. He doesn't need to. I mean, he's one of the absolute best in the world, but making up for the point before anyway that he wasn't able to capture over the table. Still 2 game points here for Jung Young Shik, and the serve is on his side. Oh, a little bit off the net there. Fan Zhendong with the counter. Wow. Again, I'm not keeping perfect tallies here, but I think Jung Young Shik has some fortune in the bank. But right here, right now, liquid cash, game point for Jung Young Shik. This is not an IOU. The forehand does it, wide to the backhand on the serve and the follow-up to the other corner, corner to corner, coast to coast, 3-2 lead for Jung Young Shik. And what this could be a massive upset, but he still has to win one more game. Game number 6, Jung Young Shik, Fan Zhendong coming up right after this. Players coming back for game number six. Rope burn on the back of Fang Zhendong right now because he's got his back against the ropes. One game away from victory, but it is a long game that is going to be a hard game to earn for Jung Young Shik. You saw that last point in replay, how Jung Young Shik had to add that side spin to keep it out of reach. Fang Zhendong not far off from a counter forehand. And the speed comes out in the backhand after the spinny forehand of Jung Young Shik to open the rally. Perfect placement, a bit into the body. Table tennis is such an amazing sport because there's so many different factors to consider in any given moment, and these players have to decide in real time, lightning speed, to play it just a fraction more into the elbow, a fraction more to the forehand. But quickly punished here, covering the middle. Fang Zhendong uses the backhand to test the wide backhand wing. Jung Young Shik steps way over for the backhand. Now, even with that flexible wrist, it's not easy to keep the ball comfortably in play after that shot.
1-3.
Now, of course, if Fang Zhendong could trade scores with Jung Young Shik right now, he'd take the 3-2 lead. But after that facial expression of Jung Young Shik left no mystery as to how he felt about that last point. Coming into game number seven with momentum for Fang Zhendong gives him a bit of confidence.
Die!
That tight serve once again, Jung Young Shik, the fighting spirit. I mean, this is again, Huai Ting. The Korean way to say fighting, basically, is the cheer that you hear, and the fighting spirit here in Korea is incredible. This is home to the 2020 World Championships right here in Busan. But the fighting spirit of Jung Young Shik brings him within one. Backhand's off the bounce, and he continues to scream and fight. First towel break. He's won 2 points in a row. He's well calibrated on these backhands. Tucks just a little bit, but again, with that long reach in the wingspan, gets a bit more racket speed. Fang Zhendong makes up for that typically with more wrist and, of course, body behind the shot, legs into it. Tough to get passive against Fang Zhendong. Now, this is one of the toughest things about beating the former world number one, one of the two most dominant players on the planet. It's natural to get passive when a shot comes in uncomfortably fast to a tough position. But Jung Young Shik manages to pull the point out here. When he finds himself back behind the table, even a little bit, he's gonna have to take some chances. He's gonna have to play aggressively. Takes him, I'd say, lower percentage shots, simply keeping the ball on the table, hoping for the next one to come back. Fang Zhendong doesn't let up when he's got an advantage. When he can get in, he won't let go of that grip. There's the angle. Once again, top and side spin. Jung Young Shik out in front. Wouldn't it be nice to have a timeout right about now? Leaping to get that right leg out of the way, wrapping the forehand around the ball. Cho, indeed. Ooh, serve drifts just a little bit too long. Fang Zhendong right there to clean up back of the table. Almost over the table, maybe. Tough to tell, but either way, had the clearance for the full forehand stroke. No flick needed. Perfect angle here, wide out, cross table. Jung Young Shik ending the rallies quickly. This is what I expected to see as soon as I played on one of these tables. Quicker rallies, flicks from over the table. And this angle, the surprise factor is high. Out of reach factor, equally high here. Ooh, break off the net, more fortune. Again, if you're keeping track of this, if someone's tallying at home, just one other fun thing to keep track of. Fang Zhendong right now, I think, still has a bit of a lead in terms of shots off the top of the net here. It was Lim Jong-hoon with a match point yesterday whose ball clipped the side of the table. Almost came back to touch the top edge of the playing surface against Ma Long, and it would have won the match, but the ball went down. Did not touch the playing surface. Goes for broke. Handcuffing serve, gets the ball where he wants it, and the third ball attack is not an easy ball. But Jung Young Shik, short stroke, has to come across the chest to abbreviate that stroke. Look at this. Manages to hold himself up. And it's only a 1-point lead. A bit of encouragement. No safety with Fang Zhendong on the other side. What a backhand. A taste of Jung Young Shik's own medicine. This ball comes firing back. A bit more topspin on it than Jung Young Shik's. But a bit less topspin than Fang Zhendong. A bit more of a fast drive there. Ball just sneaking past to tie up the score. Clever idea, not an easy shot to execute. I think it was the right choice to go for it. From a different camera angle, we might be able to see the height of that ball. But either way, saw the opening down the line. Fang Zhendong in the lead by one. It's never over until it's over. We saw that with Kasumi Ishikawa earlier today. The flick does it, forehand flick ties it back up. Dead even once again. You watch this in anticipation, wondering, could it happen? Again, for Chinese fans, there are many Chinese fans who would love to see Fang Zhendong pull this out. Probably the overwhelming amount of Chinese fans, but there are still fans around the world, plus Chinese fans, that would be excited to see the Chinese national team challenged. Look at the edge of the racket there. Is that sweat on the edge, or is it a crack in the rubber? Looks like a crack in the rubber.
8-9.
Now I have a view, and you at home have a view of the racket. Normally, if an umpire sees it, American flag in the background here, I was gonna say that if an umpire sees that, checks it, Jung Young Shik might have to pull out a spare racket. Normally that would only be checked after a table is hit. With the racket, there's contact, reason to suspect that there might be a crack in the rubber. 1 point down on the second serve. Beautiful backhand, straightens it out a bit more, plays it to the short side of the table and ties it up at the third towel break of game number six. Jung Young Shik is 2 points away from victory. He's gonna be on the receive here, but the placement fools Fang Zhendong. Man, the roar. A beast of a backhand from the roaring Jung Young Shik. But again, when it comes to power, the more powerful of the two players is on screen now, Fang Zhendong. Long fast serve pays off for Fong Jundong. It earns him a game point. 1 point away from sending this to the decider. Players are going to take their time out here right now. Fong Jundong with a lot of thinking to do. Planning out this serve, how to set up that third ball attack. Ooh! Zheng Yongshik saves the game point going to the corner that Fong Jundong is waiting on. He says, I'm going to try to play it as wide to that backhand as possible and make this uncomfortable for you. Look how low Fong Jundong gets. That stomp of frustration could have made three bottles of wine if he had enough grapes under his feet. Deuce in game number six. I obviously know nothing about wine. Wow, recovers the net. It was a break for Fong Jundong, and Zheng Yongshik now with a game and match point, his first match point. Can he do it? With the crowd behind him, on the receive here. It only takes one right now from Zheng Yongshik. There it is! Zheng Yongshik does it! He takes the match 12-10 over Fong Jundong. What a landmark victory for world number 20. The 27-year-old Zheng Yongshik is absolutely in seventh heaven right now on cloud nine. Look at this man, pulled it out. Came back in game number six. What a performance from Zheng Yongshik. The first time he is 1-6, but this is the time. And Kim Tak-soo with a good hair scrub, so proud of his student, of his player, standing ovation in the crowd. And a tough time right now for Xiaopeng in the corner with Wang Hao, but Zheng Yongshik moves on to the semifinals after a world ranking had dropped significantly from Zheng Yongshik. He is making his way back up. Wow.